So first of all, hold on. 3, 2, 1. Introduce yourself to everybody watching.
I'm Miguel Flores, fighting for the WBA world title against Leo Santa Cruz February 16 at the Microsoft Theater.
On Fox.
On Fox.
So first of all, tell me about fighting Leo. He's undefeated. He's a champion. He's very talented.
One loss.
Sorry, one loss.
To Frampton. He avenged it.
But have you been studying him?
I mean, obviously, I'm the type of fighter. I like to watch my opponents. I like to know what they're doing. Shit, I like to know when they're going to the restroom, everything. I want to know the guy, you know?
Cause he's a nice guy.
Yeah, he's a cool guy. So that's one thing, you know, I have to put aside. He's a real guy, a nice guy.
He doesn't talk trash.
He doesn't talk trash. Neither do I, you know?
But it's business.
It's business. I'm coming to try to knock his head off to feed my family. He's doing the same thing. One thing, I mean, you in this boxing game, a lot of people count you out before you even step in the ring.
True.
And with 8-ounce gloves in the ring, you know, anything could happen. I can't always promise victory because you never, like I said, never know what's going to happen. But one thing I could promise is an exciting fight. That's one thing we are going to give the fans.
500% effort. You never.
Yes, definitely. I mean, two Mexican fighters, both from Michoacan, we're going to give a great fight. You know, that's one thing we're definitely guaranteeing. I'm going to turn all the naysayers into believers.
You were at a press conference today in LA. Last time I saw you was at the announcement with Fox, and nobody knew you spoke English. That was pretty funny.
Yeah, well, nobody know. A lot of people mistake me for a Filipino or something. But yeah, I know English and Spanish. I could do interviews. Adriana from Fino Box, she's like, oh, you know Spanish, we'll do a Spanish one. Yeah, you know, I'm bilingual. I do it all.
I gotta ask you this. Let's talk about some upcoming fights. Obviously, you're fighting on February 16 here at the Microsoft Theater, correct?
Yes, correct.
First coming up, Adrian Broner, Manny Pacquiao. Give me your assessment.
Definitely, I gotta go with the hard work. Manny Pacquiao, man, you know.
They're both working hard, though, right?
Well, I mean, that's what they say, right?
I saw AB and Cap. He is working hard.
AB, this dude's skillful, talented. I just think all the negativity he has going around, you know, even if it's not, you know, him, something, you know, his warrants, him being locked up, it has to have some type of distraction on you, you know, and you
maybe
got
it's motivation.
Maybe, but like I said, but I gotta stick to the hard work, to the Filipino, you know, the one that has the seven division world champion, the hard worker, eight division. See, I don't even shit. That's so many that I can't even remember. But you gotta go with the hard work, and Manny's always focused, and you know his speed, left-handed. I don't think AB has seen anything like him.
Two guys that are close to your weight class, a little bigger. Gervonta Tank Davis, 20-0, 19 knockouts. Abner Mars, a three-division champion that has no fear. What do you think?
Oh, man. Definitely, I see the people criticizing for taking for Mars. You know, oh, well, Tank's going to run through him. Sometimes people contradict themselves. They want the fighters to fight anybody, and that's exactly what Mars is doing. He's like daring to be great, and you know that's something you gotta admire. If he falls short, then you know he did it against a top dog at 130, and if he wins, man, he's gonna go down as one of the best Mexican fighters. You know, obviously we know the cards are stacked up against them, but it, like I said, in this boxing world, man, you just never know. You can't count nobody out. I'm rooting for Mares. I hope, obviously, he's a fellow Mexican. Mares, I hope he wins. I hope he gets the big win. But you know, like I said, Davis is skilled, talented, and we'll see. You know, Gervonta Davis is another one. You know, we never know which one's gonna show up. He has distractions as well, so we gotta find out.
You're from Texas, correct?
What's your name? I'm from Texas, Houston, but I was born in Michoacan.
No. But my next question is, we're heading out with the next fight.
Okay.
We're heading out to Mikey Garcia, Errol Spence, March 16, Dallas Cowboy Stadium, Jerry's World. What do you think?
That's another one. People criticizing, why is Errol fighting a smaller guy, blah, blah, blah. But their fights are getting made, you know. Mike
Duran moved up in weight.
Yeah, exactly.
Pacquiao moved up in weight.
That's what
Sugar
I'm saying.
Mike is a four division.
You
champ.
Got all these fighters daring to be great, daring to take a bigger challenge. Mikey could stay at 35, 40, fight some of these guys that we know most likely he will beat. But he's daring to be great, taking up against Arrow. Arrow's a big ass 147 pounder, you know, and it's obvious that Arrow's the favorite once again, but as a fellow Mexican, I mean, I got a root for Mikey, but, you know, we know that Arrow's the favorite.
Who do you want to see Canelo fight next? Do you want to see him fight Charlo? Do you want to see him fight her? Do you want to see him fight Danny Jacobs, Triple G again, fight you?
I mean, if they pay some millions, I'll fight him. No,
you'll fight him? You'll do the tension versus Mayweather?
Yeah.
You'll give up all that weight? Would you spar with it for $9 million?
Where do I sign? Where do I sign? That's my question. You know.
But you do better than Tension.
Yeah, I mean, most people say it was rigged, but who knows?
No, it wasn't rigged. What could have Tension done? Let's say.
I mean, I guess it was one of them situations where you hit me hard in sparring, I'ma hit your ass back hard, and that's what happened. You know, the Japanese kid came, kind of hit Mayweather hard. Mayweather was like, "Man, calm your little ass down. I'ma, you know, don't come in here with that." As far as what was the
first question was, who should Canelo fight next?
Oh, Canelo.
See, I remember, but we're all over the place, but we're getting the information.
Canelo, I don't know if I want to see him fight Triple G again. I think this time he'll beat Triple G more convincingly, even though a lot of people say he didn't beat him, but Triple G's kind of on the downfall. Canelo's barely peaking, you know, this dude's barely 28. I would like to see him fight Danny Jacobs. You know, that's a fight that I think will complicate itself. That's the guy that I think will possess more challenge for Canelo right now. Because for me, Canelo, he's up there with the top three pound for pound.
You faced off with Leo today.
Yes.
You see anything in his eyes?
No, I see a guy that's working hard, and you know, we're boxers, man. We're not, a lot of people are like, "Oh, he's scared to fight this guy." Man, we're not scared to fight nobody. We're warriors. We're willing to die in that ring. Just a matter of, you know, a lot of negotiations. It takes more than two guys wanting to fight each other for a fight to happen.
You're right.
It's a lot of negotiations. So if his fight didn't happen with Gary Russell or with Valdez, it's negotiations. A lot of people don't understand that. You know, the opportunity presented itself for me, I'm not going to pass up on it. I mean, I'm going to be able to feed my family, you know, basically for the rest of my life. I'm not going to pass on it. But I didn't see anything in his eyes. A lot of people were like, "Oh, I saw fear in his eyes." Nah, I saw a kid that's probably working. He's probably going to go work out right now. So, shit, when I get home, I'm going to go for a run because I can't let him outwork me. You know, I see a kid that's going to work hard, and I'm going to work hard myself, and that's going to produce a great fight.
Tell all the fans where to follow you on social media.
Definitely. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter, @El_Michoacano2. It will be on there, man. Like I said, a lot of people calling me a taxi driver. That's something I've been making fun of. So
you have to respect all fighters. Why would they call you that?
Nah,
you're a pro boxer. Yeah,
but you know people, you know media.
They write you
off
until you do something very impressive. Then there's no room in a bandwagon.
That's why I said, I mean, I'm going to turn all these naysayers into believers. Trust me. Even if we're going to put up a great fight and all these people are going to be like, "Man, that was the media, you guys are not going to have to look for a fight of the year 2019. That's going to be it. And it's also going to be upset of the year.
As one of the most hated people in the world that's talking to you right now, every day, tens of thousands of people tell me, you got to ignore the haters.
You got to run it off.
You got to be made out of
I laugh with it. A lot of people are like, why do you feel offended? I'm like, I don't feel offended.
Who cares?
That shit, I've been through
just
so much. Yeah, I've been through so much in my career, in my life, man. This is just another bump. It just rolls off.
It rolls off me.
Hey,
at least they know you now.
They know me now. I'm getting out there. I'm getting my Instagram followers up.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. One more time, where they follow you?
@El_Michoacano2.
Make sure you follow and stay tuned for EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram